crisis is getting in some states across the country. As the Wisconsin legislature meets in special session right now, the governor says he is ready to call out the National Guard in his war with the state unions. Welcome to America Live. I'm Megyn Kelly. This is a stunning story. Newly elected Governor Scott Walker is trying to fill a $3.5 billion budget hole this week without raising taxes. In order to do that, he is going further than any other governor when it comes to challenging state workers. And he is now saying that he is ready to mobilize National Guard troops. He's already reached out to them to give them the heads up, if he needs to deal with the fallout from those union workers. Trace Gallagher live from our West Coast newsroom. I think it's unprecedented.
It is indeed, Megyn, and keep in mind the state of Wisconsin has 175,000 public employees, and experts say most of them are going to be very angry if this passes. Now keep in mind, even Republicans who support this are saying this may set off a firestorm at the state capitol, which is why the governor, Scott Walker, says he is willing to mobilize the National Guard for, and I'm quoting here, whatever repercussions arise. The governor is planning to take away nearly all collective bargaining rights beginning on July 1st, which means that salaries would be frozen. You'd only have cost of living increases. Any other increases would have to be voted on. The contracts would last only 1 year. Public employers could no longer collect union dues, but public workers would have to contribute 5.8% of their salary to their pension fund, 12.6% of their salary to health care costs. Here's the context. Wisconsin has had collective bargaining now for more than 50 years, and the Democrats in the state, their hands are pretty much tied because the Republicans control both the state assembly and the state senate by pretty fair margins.
This is quite a unilateral action. He's got to get the support of the legislature, but as you point out, it's GOP control. Coming up top of the next hour, Trace, we will be joined by a top Democrat in the state who is not happy about the governor's plan. Also, we'll have some late-breaking details about what we've learned about his plan and what it means for these unions and what they're just going to have to do in other states.
Occurred today. You are the losers.
Fight for jobs, we fight for hope. Yeah. Devil's on the way. God bless you. Love you so much. Yeah.